Welcome to my Road to Completion Guide for Astro's Playroom. If you haven't watched episode 0, make sure to do that now because it contains very important information about this guide. The link to episode 0 is in my pinned comment. Complete the tutorial to become familiar with the controller since it plays a huge part in this game. Climb the wall on the left to find the first puzzle piece. This action unlocks a trophy called One Down, Lots More to Go. Climb the wall and cross to the other side to get the next puzzle piece. Thank you. fly down to the platform below for the next puzzle piece. Warp to and from GPU Jungle and Cooling Springs to activate fast travel points we can use later in the run. We can throw objects to get extra coins, defeat enemies, and trigger events in the environment. Let's make our way to Memory Meadow. The next puzzle piece is located on top of the right platform. Follow me to the next puzzle piece. Walk to the edge of the platform and wait for the can to hit us to get the pain trophy. Always trigger checkpoints to ensure you never lose progress. Cross the gap to get the PlayStation controller artifact and a trophy called In Mint Condition. Go around the corner and grab the next puzzle piece on the edge of the platform. climb the wall behind us and pull the cables to get the PlayStation Mouse artifact. Cross the gap and climb the wall to find the next piece of the puzzle. Fall down and stand under the canopy for a few seconds to pop the Jason trophy. Follow me to fast lane fields and knock down all the bowling pins to pop the wipeout trophy. The next puzzle piece is hidden under the ramp on the left. The next puzzle piece is surrounded by musical notes on the road. Follow me to the next checkpoint and take a left. Move slowly across the thin path to get the PlayStation memory card. Drop down, roll through the bowling pin, and cross the platforms on the right to get the PlayStation game disc. Use the bounce pads to find the next puzzle piece. Follow the path, but slow down after the bounce pad. We need to get the next puzzle piece on the small path to the right. Climb the first wall on the left and follow the path to find the next puzzle piece. Pull the cables up ahead to get the PS1 LCD monitor. Use the duck to fly back to the main path and grab the next puzzle piece on the floating platform. Thank you. The next puzzle piece is very easy to miss. Go past the second checkpoint and you'll see it up in the air above an electronic floor trap. After getting the puzzle piece, follow the left path to get the PlayStation multitap. The next puzzle piece is above the first TV up ahead. Knock down all the pins in the center to find the next puzzle piece. Use the chute on the left to get the next puzzle piece. Check the icy path up ahead to get the next puzzle piece. It's very easy to roll past it, so make sure to go back if you miss it. Move slowly across the icy path on the left to get the DualShock controller. Get the final puzzle piece in Memory Meadow to pop the next trophy. Follow the path on the left to get the PlayStation artifact. run or fast travel to CPU Plaza and grab the next puzzle piece in the underground area. Hit 20 other bots and have them follow you to get the last guy trophy. Hold square to charge a punch and hit 10 bots at once to pop the Project Neo trophy. Travel to SSD Speedway and I'll see you in the next episode. Be good.